Welcome to our brand new season of Casa Daza. When you're surrounded by beauty like this, it's so inspiring. I'm in Taal Vista Hotel, and they've been gracious enough to host us. And guess what? You know, they have their own organic vegetable and herb garden, which I'm going to use for our dishes. You know, my dishes today are very simple. Their ingredients are easy to find, and they're doable, and they're delicious. So get your cell phones ready, take a picture of our recipes, and follow me on Casa Daza here on Metro Channel. Our first pork dish today is something of a controversy to many, and I'll tell you why. This dish is called Sinampalukang Baboy. Now, a lot of people, when I told them the idea, they said, "Di ba sinampalukan is chicken?" Well, who said so? You know what I mean? So my point is, create something of your own. So I thought about creating a Sinampalukang Baboy. To enjoy this very comforting, tasty dish, we will need cooking oil, garlic, ginger, onions, tomatoes, some pork cubes, pork casin, water, sampaluk juice, ground pepper, sili pangsigang, fish sauce or patis, and kangkong. So what we will do is we'll start sauteing. So let's add in our oil first. So we're going to start sauteing our garlic. Okay, now I make sure when I create the recipes that the ingredients are easy to find, they're inexpensive, and you know, of course, number one, they have to be delicious. So I just added the garlic and the ginger. We'll add in our onions. Then let's add in our tomatoes. Yan. And you can see, actually, the recipe is very similar to a sinigang, di ba? Then what we will do is we'll add in some pork cubes. Okay, this is going to add a little flavor. And remember, taste is very important. Then what we will do is let's add in our pork. Yan. You know, I don't know if you noticed, but my ingredients are arranged according to sequence of use, so that, and they're pre-portioned, so all I have to do is just pick it up and throw it in. While I'm waiting for the pork to brown just a little bit, parang sear it a little bit, I'm gonna show you, these are raw sampalok. You know, sometimes I eat this in color green. They're actually very, very good. So what you want to do with this, you just boil it, and then the moment it softens, you want to mash it, and then you strain it like I've done here. Now, the sinampalukang manok that I had before was so good, and they put sampalok leaves. Ooh, so let's do that also. Why not, diba? Yeah, so we just put all of these together. I don't know if you hear the sizzle of the pork was, it was simmering. Now it's frying because the oils have come out. Okay, now key here is to tenderize the pork. So we are going to add in our water. Yeah, make sure that the pork is submerged in water. What you want to do here is cover it and simmer it. Siguro mga 45 minutes. Let's see. The only flavoring, if you remember here, are the pork cubes, remember? Okay. Let me taste. Okay, you know what I taste? Of course, I taste the pork cubes. But you know what else I taste? You remember I added the leaves of the sampalok? Yun, lumalabas na yung konting sourness. Just make sure, very important, is the pork is tender. Now, the reason I tasted this is I want to see the development of flavors. Now, we are going to add in our sampalok juice. Mix this a little bit. Add our pepper. If you notice, there's a lot of pepper. A lot of siling haba. There's a little kick sa anghang ng konti. Mix all of this together. And then, we are going to taste it again. Don't double dip, ha? O, yan. Tasting. You know, there's a kick already from the siling aba and the sourness from the sampalok juice. Now, you talk about sinigang, you talk about bulalo, kansi, you talk about nilagang baka. All of those, puchero, the seasoning is patis. Yan na. Taste, you know, very, very important is always taste, okay? You know what? I think it's perfect. It's perfect. Ooh. But, you know, if you want to have some patis on the side with mashed finger sili, panalo. Ooh. And then at this point, since our pork is tender already, we are just going to add in, ooh, masarap yung kit. Kangkong. Okay. And after, siguro mga 3 minutes, turn off the heat because I want the heat of our broth or sinampalukan to cook the kangkong and still have it crunchy. Cover this. So there you have it. Tender, sour, spicy sinampalukan na baboy that you can do at home. You have to believe me. This is very, very good. Coming up, I have another delicious dish that's easy and fun to prepare. Thai basil pork. Learn my recipe right here at Casa Daza. In the early 90s, we had a Thai restaurant called Mai Thai. This was in EDSA Central, and we had 3 Thai chefs. You know, many of the dishes I had never come across before because before then, I had not ever been to Bangkok. But you know what? When I tried a Thai dish before, and I remember the first dish I tried was a green mango salad, I immediately fell in love with this. Now, we had many Thai dishes in the restaurant. One of the most popular dishes, which I thought was so simple, is this one I'm going to make, Thai basil pork. My recipe for this Thai basil pork calls for just a few ingredients. Cooking oil, garlic, red finger sili, basil leaves, ground pork, sugar, soy sauce, fish sauce or patis, and oyster sauce. There are 4 characteristics in a Thai dish. Eh? It's salty, it's sour, it's sweet, it's spicy, and I just love it. Let's heat up our pan. We'll heat some oil. Yan. Make sure that all your ingredients are ready. Huh? So let me have our oyster sauce. I have our patis, soy sauce, and sugar. Okay. This I'm going to mix together and set this aside because I'm going to use this as our seasoning. Okay, now I'm going to saute some garlic. You know, just by looking at the ingredients, this is the type that will make you parang swallow. Okay, sili, finger sili. Yan. Okay, then we don't want the garlic to brown. We put in our ground pork. If you don't have ground pork, or if you don't want to use ground pork, you may use ground chicken, ground squid, fish, beef, what have you, no? So make sure that you mash the pork because I don't want chunks of pork in our Thai basil dish, okay? I don't know if you noticed this, though. There is some reddish color that's coming out. That's the blood from the pork. That's an indication that the pork is not cooked yet, diba? Now, what I want to do here is toast the pork a little bit. What will happen is that the liquid of the pork is going to simmer and come out, and it will cook the pork. From the simmering sound, the moment that liquid has evaporated, it will transform into a frying sound. Now, I don't know if you can hear this, but the simmering has transformed into frying because it's the oil now that's toasting our ground pork. Look, oh, there's a little color. Now, I don't want to taste this. Why? Because if you look back at the ingredients, it has zero taste, zero seasoning. Now, you remember the mixture of soy sauce, oyster sauce, sugar, and the other ingredient, patis. This is what I will flavor it with. Yan, ayan na. This one is infused with flavor. It's so funny because a dish like this, you can eat 3 tablespoons and 2 cups of rice. It's that kind of a dish. So salty, sour, spicy, and sweet. And then, at this point, we will add our Thai basil. If you don't have Thai basil, you can use any kind of basil. It's fine, okay? Yan. Now, we are going to turn off the heat. And I'm going to make the heat of the pork heat the Thai basil, and that'll bring out the flavors. Ang bango-bango nito. This smells so good. You know what I want to do? I want to toast it a little more. But let me taste it, huh? Let me taste this with a basil leaf. Boom. Sarap. Very, very good. You know, some of the sauces you can put over steamed rice, and there's a kick from the spice. There's spiciness, there's sweetness, there's sourness, and there's saltiness. Absolutely delicious and simple. You saw how I made it, diba? So there you have it, Thai basil pork. Next up, we're making green bell pepper stir fry. So stay tuned to Casa Daza. For our last dish today, we are going to make something very simple. It's just stir-fried pork. You know, this dish, if you will notice from the ingredients alone, you'll be able to tell it has Chinese influence. This is a dish that I would describe as a Filipinized Chinese dish. This one is called green bell pepper stir-fried pork. This simple but delicious dish needs green bell peppers, garlic, ginger, pork kasim cut into strips, soy sauce, oyster sauce, honey, pepper, and oil. It's actually very, very simple to make. All we have to do is just heat up our pan with some oil. Wait for that to curl a little bit. That's an indication that the oil is getting warm. And if you notice, I'm arranging everything according to sequence of use. So I just pick up and I pick up. I don't measure anymore. Okay, so garlic. We add in our ginger. So we're infusing our oil with the flavors of garlic and ginger. Yan. And then we have some pork. We'll add our pork first. Yan. And we will saute this until the pinkish colors are no longer visible. Okay, so we have our seasoning ingredients here. We have pepper, we have honey. Yan. We have our oyster sauce. So if you notice, the pepper is a little bit, it's a lot of pepper. We have soy sauce. Okay. And then we mix this very, very well. So, typical Chinese dish. Sweet, salty, slightly spicy. Go back to our pork. Yan na yun. Okay, very important to remove the pinkish color because that's the indication that they're not done yet. I just want to make sure that my pork is fully cooked before I set this aside, no? Just leave it for a while. Yan. Okay. Now, the pinkish color is no longer visible. What we will do is we will set this aside. Sarap. I love the smell. You know, the predominant smell is the ginger. Okay. I have my bell peppers. Okay. Saute this a little bit just to soften it and to extract the flavors. Okay. Yan. Just follow the recipe to the dot, no? And trust me, you'll be able to cook all of these dishes. Okay. Okay, now our bell peppers are done. If you want to add a little color, you may add some red bell peppers also if you like. Be creative. It's up to you, really, huh? And then, we add back our pork. Yan. Then we add back our, remember the honey, soy sauce, pepper, di ba? Yan. Maybe as you go along, oh, you see? And very important is you have to make sure there is a uniform color because that's an indication that your dish is receiving all the flavors that it has to, okay? I can taste the kick of the pepper and the sweetness of the honey. Very good. Very, very good. This you have to make at home. It's just stir-fried pork with green pepper. You have to try this. Sarap. So there you have it. Green bell pepper stir-fried pork. Sinampalukang Baboy, green bell pepper stir-fried pork, and Thai basil pork. Oh my God. So good. Sinampalukang Baboy. Very tender sour meat, a little bit spicy. Green bell pepper stir-fried pork. And Thai basil pork. Okay, let me think what I want to start with here. I'll try this pork. Ooh, I can tell the pork is so tender. Look at that. Okay, let me put some of this here. And look what I have here. I have, of course, steamed rice. Yes, steamed rice. And I have patis with sili. Yeah, no, look at that, mashed finger sili. Ooh, look at that pork, it's so tender. And this sour broth. Oh my God. So good. The pork is sour, a little bit spicy. Your saltiness from the patis, and it is so good. Oh, wow. Rice, yan ang kalaban mo. I'm gonna eat so much rice. Ground pork with Thai basil. Okay. You know, in spite of it being windy, I can smell. The aroma somehow finds its way to my nostrils. Wow, sarap. Many of our Filipino dishes have the characteristics of actually Asian cuisine, yung salty, sour, sweet, and spicy. Very, very good. Look at this. Actually, I don't know. This ground pork, get some rice, and just mix it. Wow, you out there. Especially those who I've spoken to and tell me, you know, I want your show, but I don't cook. You know, take the giant step. prepare all the ingredients, portion it, measure it, and then start assembling it. Trust me, you can make any of these dishes. And believe me, they are delicious. Your family will jump with joy. They're gonna kiss you and tell you, Mom or Dad, sarap nito. Yung stir fry naman, it's very simple. This is what I'd call a Filipino Chinese influenced dish. It'll require a lot of rice also. That's the bad thing about the dish I just made. You're gonna eat a lot of rice with this. Very good, very, very good. You know, beautiful scenery, it's nice, windy, it's cool, you have delicious food. And you know what I noticed also? Eh, kaya naman pala maganda itong mga plates natin. It's from my happy home of Happy Umpauko. Happy! Thank you for lending us all these wonderful plates and serving plates. Sana one day we can work together. See you next week here on Casa Daza.